Stick around. We're going to be back with nominations for the California Music Awards in just a moment. And welcome back to the show. Our next guest, whom you know quite well, is actually the founder of BAM Magazine, which happens to be the sponsor of the California Music Awards.
And you know, BAM Magazine is no longer on the newsstands because Dennis has moved on to other projects, but the awards live on and happen very soon here in town. We welcome Dennis Erickhine. Welcome, Dennis.
Thank you.
Hi, Dennis.
How you doing?
How are you?
Great.
The question folks want to know often is, when did the BAMMies become the California Music Awards, and also why?
Well, I believe that we announced that entire thing on your show originally on the radio, and that
we
is
did.
2 years ago, we had gone for 20 years of doing the Bay Area Music Awards, and it was fabulous, but we were realizing that a lot of the bands and musicians in Southern California wanted to be a part of this thing, and because BAM at the time was throughout the state, we decided to open it up to everybody. It's been fantastic. It's because of that we've had No Doubt, we've had Dr. Dre, we've had Snoop Doggy Dogg, you know, so we've added a whole new group of musicians to be a part of the BAMMies. And this year, with the demise of BAM Magazine, we added Tower Records as the new sponsor, so it's now the Tower Records California Music Awards.
So does it change the show in any other way, how bands or people are nominated, or what the categories are? Has any of that really changed?
No, it's actually exactly the same. What we did before, and with the help of Pulse Magazine, Towers Magazine, we contacted all the music journalists throughout the state the way we've done all the years in the past. We sent out a nominating ballot. They came back with the five best in each category. And the cool thing, though, is that this year, at every Tower Records in California, there are ballots behind all of the CDs that are up for nomination or up for awards. There's also the Tower Records website where you can vote online. And we're already getting way more ballots in, and it's only been open, you know, the balloting's only been going on a couple of days, but they're already pouring in, so we're excited about that.
Yeah, well, initially, I know it was hard for you to decide with the BAMMies anyway, because there were bands like Cake, who played a lot in the city, but were out of Sacramento.
Exactly.
There's guys like Tom Waits, born in San Diego, cut his teeth in Los Angeles, but now lives in the North Bay, so
yeah.
What do you do?
Yeah, what do we do? That was our big question, and we decided to come up with this whole darn California thing. The other one was, bands like Counting Crows. You know, they're from the Bay Area, but now most of them live in Los Angeles. So does that mean we don't count them?
Yeah.
Or
you don't count the crows?
So we counted. We ended up counting the crows.
Uh-huh.
Yes, thank you.
Should we get into some of the categories, like Outstanding Album?
I'd love to.
Okay.
I'd love to.
The
exciting thing about Outstanding Album is the 52-year-old Wonder Guy.
Bay Area guy?
Bay Area guy, Carlos Santana, who is so huge right now that not only did he have the best-selling album of last year, but he's already got the best-selling album of this year with the same album. So his career is amazing. And one of the exciting things about Carlos is that he's got so many new fans this year that people have actually been sending email to his office saying, do you have any other albums out?
Which is
not even knowing he's got like 30
of them. Yeah,
that's
and like it's done well for so
old
long.
The old joke about a guy dating a younger woman. Not me. And the girlfriend listens to a Paul McCartney album and goes, this guy's all right. Did he have any bands before Wings?
That's right. And that is an amazingly old joke.
Maybe you've heard of the Beatles. Or what else? Heavy metal rock band. You got Rage Against the Machine and Metallica.
Rage Against the Machine, which is probably the most socially conscious heavy metal band of all time, is up for an award, as is Metallica. Both of them, by the way, are also going to get special awards at the BAMMies this year. Rage Against the Machine for public service, because they are the most do-gooding communists on the face of the earth.
Zach is very involved.
Right, exactly. And Metallica is getting a special award for their album and show that they did with the orchestra and Michael Heeman. So they're getting an award for excellence, along with everything else that they were nominated for.
And then there's also rock and pop.
Yes.
A lot of people in
rock
that category.
It's one of the great categories for California music forever.
Yeah.
And, we have all of the tradition of all those great groups. This year, we've got bands like Red Hot Chili Peppers, who just have not been able to slow down. I mean, they're still as hot as ever.
I was going to say, this band, I remember, how many, 8, 9 years ago?
Right.
What was it, Blood Sugar Sex Magik, was that theirs? And they were just crazy then. People were packing the place to see them.
And everybody thought they were a hippie band. So that, it didn't take long to forget about that one. Another huge one is Third Eye Blind.
Yeah.
Stephen Jenkins has kind of put himself on the very top of the rock heap, and the band has a great new album out, so lots of great stuff happening there.
What about with Zach? Okay, that leopard skin jacket?
I can only assume.
I'm sure it's faux. It's faux.
Exactly.
We can hope it is.
I'm sure it's just little dots, so we're okay with that.
All right. Outstanding female vocalist. Who do we got?
Well, another of these you know, first-timers on the rock charts, you would think, along with Carlos Santana, is Cher. Cher, a year ago, my family was in London, and it was the biggest song in Europe. And everyone was saying it could only happen in Europe, it could never happen. Cher is just a has-been in the United States. Within weeks after that, it went to the top of the charts here, and it's been that way for most of the year. The tour she went on was gigantic, and so she is also totally evergreen with a fabulous song.
You know, when I looked at this list, I had to ask somebody, does Cher live in California? Because I always associate her with New York.
Oh,
she
interesting.
Does live in
yeah.
California.
No, totally,
as well.
Totally a Californian, though, you know, she's kind of a citizen of the world.
Yeah. Will she be bringing her silly self up? Do you know yet? How far in advance do you know if individuals
Well, the one we know for sure, is Smash Mouth, who is also up for a bunch of awards.
San Jose Kids, originally.
Exactly right. Yeah, in the tradition of the Doobie Brothers and the Chocolate Watch Band is now Smash Mouth, and they were supposed to be one-hit wonders. That was the deal.
When they came out with that hit about, three, four years ago, everybody said novelty hit,
right.
They were one hit, and they're gone.
So they've already had two hits from this album. They got a great songwriter who's also up for a songwriter. Steve Harwell is a great singer. Many people have said he sounds like he's British when he's singing. Well, I'll take it. Sounds good to me.
And we've got, let's see, overall best group. Third Eye Blind, again, is in that.
That's right. Third Eye Blind is up there. It's
Rage again.
Yeah, Rage. I mean, it's a great category. The California is made for bands.
Yeah.
So we've got them all over the place. We've also got, in the hip-hop category, Dr. Dre, who last year we gave an award for Lifetime Achievement. Now, this is a cool Lifetime Achievement award when you think about the fact that he's not even 35. So I think we're giving him an award for before and for everything coming up afterwards.
Well, I won't make any jokes about the lifespan of rap artists, so we'll move on. 35 is a good time for a Lifetime Achievement Award for the world of hip-hop.
Just sure, Johnny. We just wanted to make sure we got it in there in time.
Male vocalist. We also have a songwriter. And one of my boys from the North Bay, you know my favorite guy.
Tom Waits.
Tom Waits is
How did I know? How could I even know it would be Tom Waits? Yeah, this is exciting. Tom Waits has been raising a family in just outside the Bay Area. He's been living up here. He does his music. He goes off and writes scores for movies and acts in movies, yeah. And then comes back and lives in a small town, the name of which I'm not going to mention, because a whole bunch of our viewers would probably go and hang
Including
with
him. Including
Johnny.
Well,
that's
sure
what I'm thinking.
Don't tell Johnny where he is.
I'm very aware that the last guy I'm going to tell us, Johnny.
I think Johnny's goal in life is just to meet Tom Waits.
But somewhere with him, right?
His last album, he made the mistake of one of the last cuts on the album is come on up to the house.
See?
And see me sometime.
It's an absolute, you know, request
to do that.
That's right. That's right.
Also, Adam Duritz is in that category as
Adam
well.
Adam Duritz is one of my favorite singers, and it's so wonderful that a guy like him can have the success he's had. He's a cross between Van Morrison and every punk hero that's come along.
And he's got Eddie Grant's hair, if you remember it. He's from the Counting Crows, of course, for people.
And now we all find out that it's faux, you know, or whatever. It's not, you know, they're extensions. So.
And is he still dating Miss Friends? What's her name? Courtney Cox?
No, she's married to David Arquette.
Well, yeah, as each one gets married off, you know, he's got to go find new whatever. You know,
it's interesting because he's so well known also for his lyrics in the songs, and he's like an English literature major or something like that.
Exactly. Yeah. Before the band signed, or before they got really going, he contacted Bam and said, you know, he said, I think I've got some really good songs now. He said, I've learned some new chords. And I just thought, oh, good, the kids learned some new chords. But actually, the chords he learned were real good.
Dennis, thanks for dropping by. Folks can vote at www.towerrecords.com, and the Bammies are California Music Awards are April 8th at the Bill Graham Civic right here in San Francisco.
And that
Tower
would be a copy of Bam.
This is our new publication. No, this is This Week in Contra Costa County.
Ooh.
And I just want to show you how much we care about this show. There it is. It's here's Johnny.
Right on the cover.
That's right.
Leave a copy for us, will
I'll
you, Dennis?
I'll be glad to.
Thank you, sir.